That's that nigga that can get all the weed for me. You know what I mean? Hey, oh, that's that nigga that can get me a couple of Percocets here and there. Let me see if I can bring that man. Oh, here we go. I just opened the page right up to
you. Let me scoot up a little closer.
Brethren shall thou set king over thee. Thou mayest not set a stranger over thee, which is not thy brother. Now, these are brothers, right? These are brothers,
right?
Here's the one.
What's up, man?
Ain't no guy here.
Still alive.
The one in Congress, the Senate, those devils that's right there, the one that's one downtown in the jailhouse or whatever. Look, I'm riding down down 104, and I'm seeing signs posted all up and down 104. They said,
you can't walk on the freeway.
Lawless, vote Lawless for sheriff. Vote, that's his name, Lawless.
His name is Lawless?
His name is Lawless.
Oh, shit.
Vote Lawless for sheriff. And that's what it is, right?
Yeah.
That's the Esau don't even follow his own motherfucking laws, you know? He don't follow his own motherfucking
laws. That's why Revelation 2 and 10 said the devil shall cast you into prison. Let's go ahead and read it.
Sirach 12 and 11. Or Sirach 10. It says, never trust thine enemy, for like as iron rusted, so is his wickedness.
Right. Esau, the Edomite, you know?
Though he humble himself and go crouching.
Moses wasn't the greatest speaker. You know what I mean? Moses came to speak right. Yep. So people make fun of the way we talk all the time. But the Lord said he gave the truth to babes. Hey, let me get that precept. Go ahead with that.
Yet take good heed, beware of him. Thou shalt be unto him as thou hast wiped the looking glass. Thou shalt know that his rest have not been altogether wiped. His rest have not been altogether wiped away.
I got a precept for what he was talking about. Matthew 11 and 25. At that time, Yahushua answered and said, thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and has revealed them unto babes. You know what I mean? So you got these wise, so-called wise people. They speak in perfect English, you know, and they use them big million-dollar words. But really, they ain't got no truth. The Lord gave the truth to us.
That's right, brother. You know, no matter how it comes out, he still gave it to us.
Then he said he chose the simple of the world to confound the wise. What was that? Yeah, so the Lord ain't looking for, like, because most of them people in them colleges, they grew up rich, they got money. It costs money to go to them colleges. The Lord said it was hard for a rich man to enter.
Jeremiah 9:23. Thus saith Yahweh, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, neither let the mighty man in his might. Let not the rich man glory in his riches, but let him that glory in this, that he understandeth and knoweth me, that I am the power which execute loving kindness, judgment, and righteousness in the earth.
Yeah, true riches is this knowledge. Coming out here and we telling these people America's about to be destroyed. America's gonna be destroyed by thermonuclear fire. And then we're gonna be in the kingdom. There ain't gonna be no more America. There's gonna be no more faggots, no more whores. It's gonna be beautiful. Go ahead.
It's gonna be smooth sailing
over there. Yeah,
it's gonna be smooth.
That's right.
Raise the dead, cast out the devil. Freely ye have received, freely give.
All right, freely receive, freely give, right? So we ain't out here charging people $5 for the DVD, you know what I mean? We're gonna charge y'all $20 an hour, just like workshop, you know what I mean? We give you all this information, all this truth for free. Go ahead.
It says, provide neither gold nor silver nor brass in your purses, nor script for your journey, neither two coats, neither shoes, nor yet staffs, for the workman is worthy of his meat. And into whatsoever city or town you shall enter, inquire who is in it is worthy, and there abide there until you go thence. And when you come into an house, salute it. Come, I'm sorry. And if the house be worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it not worthy, let your peace return to you. And whosoever would
not... No, it didn't say peace to everybody, did it?
Okay.
It didn't say it. Go ahead.
And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear your words, when you depart out of that house or city, shake off the dust of your feet.
Yeah, so sometimes you just can't keep trying to teach somebody. They ain't going to get it. Go on to the next person.
We ain't sitting on worrying about waking up every last person. That ain't gonna happen.
Most people just ain't gonna get it. And we're okay with that. You know what I mean? We already know that. The scripture said many are called but few are chosen. That's most people just gonna look at you like you're crazy. Go ahead.
To you, it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city.
Right, so if you teach the people they don't get it, fuck them. Because they're going to get destroyed like Sodom and Gomorrah got destroyed. And how did Sodom and Gomorrah get destroyed? By fire. So that's what's coming, is that fire. They're going to eat missiles. So if someone rejects the word, they're just going to eat missiles. They're going to die in that thermonuclear flame and that fire.
As sheep in the midst of wolves, be therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves.
Yes, yeah, you see the wolves out here just ravaging beasts.
But beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, they will scourge you in the synagogues, and ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake. For testimony against them of the Gentiles. When they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given unto you the same hour what ye shall speak.
Like, you know, a lot of times people call the cops on you.
Father will speak it in you, and the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father, the child, and the children shall raise up against their parents and cause them to be put to death.
Damn.
And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake.
So it says, you shall be hated of all men for my name's sake. And that's why a lot of people, they got a problem with the truth. They got a problem with the scripture. The problem with the apostles. And they hate and despise the apostles because we come in the name of Yahweh Shai, and they hate the words of Yahweh Shai, you know? Because they cut their spirit. These people, we're dealing with a bunch of wicked devils. Go ahead.
He that endureth to the end shall be saved.
He that endureth to the end shall be saved. So you gotta endure, meaning you gotta keep teaching the truth if you can't stop. Go ahead.
When they persecute you,
flies is talking about is the flies buzzing on a pallet of shit.
Yeah, I made a video about it. A picture of a pallet of
shit. Oh, yeah?
That's an evil, that's a wicked nigga, ain't
it? I've been
that's
known he was wicked, nigga. Though.
Yeah, we knew it too from him. Yeah.
They was trying to give him a chance.
Yeah, I mean, you're supposed to, though.
You know, they like...
He was trying. Well, pretending, I mean. I said trying, he pretended.
Man, I knew he wasn't right.
Yeah. Ain't no way he's looking for fame.
Bro, he used to make all kind of videos about us back in the day talking shit. back in 2010.
He's double minded. He's double minded.
He's got an effeminate spirit on him.
Oh, brother.
Yeah, we talk about you too hard.
That motherfucker, he was on a Chicago live show. That nigga was talking shit like, you know, that house thing.
Saying that's going to happen, you just don't know. You gotta watch for it and be ready for it.
I can't wait, man. Oh, man. Oh, sleepless nights.
And if Trump does get in, they're gonna burn everything down. So it's gonna be beautiful regardless. Whatever happens, whether if Hillary wins, shit, they're gonna have the good old boys come out and cut. You know what I mean? They're gonna round up. The spirit of division is reaching its peak, its pinnacle. Because the Lord said he came to bring division. That's all you see out here is division. Hey, let's finish up that match, unless you got a preset. I didn't really get to the point yet. But.
Fear them not, therefore, for there's nothing covered that shall not be revealed and hid. That shall not be known.
Right, like that's what we're talking about. He let everything be known. The spirit lets everything be known. I've been known to do what right, but now the spirit let it know that he ain't right, you know? He just revealed himself. Like last week, that guy we was talking to, you remember him? He's trying to be Mr. Nice Guy, Mr. Polite, Mr. Peaceful, and then by the end of the day, he wanted to fight us. Yeah, what was he supposed to? And the spirit revealed his ass.
That speak ye in light, but in here and in here that preach ye upon housetops. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill itself, but rather fear them which are able to destroy both soul and body in hell.
Right, so a lot of people won't come out here and teach because they're afraid of these rats and roaches out here. All these little private syllabuses. You don't come out here and teach the violence. You may have people try to fight us, put weapons on you, but you can't be afraid of them. They're gonna kill you. They're gonna kill your body. They can't do shit. Really, it's like on Star Wars. They kill Obi-Wan Kenobi and he got stronger. That's a horrible metaphor, but yeah. But you think about it though, you can't kill you, bro. Because they can't kill your spirit. As soon as they kill your flesh, you go back to the Father. You know what I mean? So they didn't stop nothing. And all they do is they turn you into a martyr. Israelites out, bro, and they stoned him to death. You know what I mean? He didn't say, oh, wait, I'm sorry, I take it back. Now, you did it to the end, bro. Oh, go ahead. That'd be a way to go out. A lot of brothers who got killed for doing the work of the Lord, like William Tyndale. They burned his ass. They burned him at the stake because he translated the Bible into English so his people could read the Bible. They burned him at the stake for that. Can you imagine him burning the stake just because you was doing the work of the Lord? Can you imagine that? Yeah, they hung him up, crucified him upside down. They crucified Andrew sideways. That's where you get the sideways cross. That's on a Scotland flag and a Jamaican flag. You got some? Dangerous everywhere he went. It sounds like a rough journey.
One false brother and really greediness and painfulness, watching emotion, hunger, thirst, fast, cold, nakedness, besides those things that are without that which come upon me daily in care of all the churches.
Well, Paul was going through hell, getting the shit beat out of him, got stoned. We be out here teaching. They'll throw piss on you. One day they threw a brick of firecrackers at us.
Remember they threw that cup of spit on the little guy?
Yeah, tobacco spit.
Yeah, that's some foul spit. Ooh.
Some dip spit.
They fell right out though.
That's what they'll say, he's evil, he killed all kind of people. I'm like, yeah, you're right. Like, we know that.
Especially if it's coming out correctly. It's gonna sound like some bullshit.
It sounds, I mean, the Lord, he's the king of terrors. He created life and death. So if the God you worship didn't create create death and life, did create peace and happiness, and created terror and fucking, what's another word, destruction and desolation. If your God didn't do that, it means your God doesn't exist.
Value than many sparrows. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men,
read this again, read it.
Whoso therefore shall confess me before men.
Whoso therefore shall confess me before men. How do you confess the Lord before men? You gotta do the work. You gotta go teach on the streets. Teaching on the streets, you know, making videos, doing whatever you can.
Go ahead. Him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven.
So yeah, you gotta confess the name of the Lord before men. And then the Lord will confess you before the Father, the Heavenly Father. And which also proves what? The Yahweh Shai, that the Son of God is not God himself. You know, people talk about the Trinity. And they'll say so-called Jesus is God. Well, this proves that. Doesn't it? Because you just read it and it said what? If you confess Yahweh Shai's name before men, he's going to confess you before the Father. Showing you there's a distinction between a father and a son. Because you know the majority of people, they think that Yahweh Shai is the Most High.
Yeah, they got it all.
That's what they think. They got that shit all messed up, man.
Go ahead. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him while I also deny me before my Father which is in heaven,
before his Father which is in heaven.
Go ahead.
Think not that I come to send peace on earth.
Right. The Lord said, think not that I come to send peace. And this was just going what we were going to talk about, how the Lord created death and destruction. You know what I mean? The Lord created war. What's that? Exodus 15 and 3 says, Yahweh is a man of war. Yahweh is his name. Read that again.
Think not that I come to send peace on earth. I come not to send peace, but a sword.
So do y'all see peace right here? This is a peaceful, happy fucking place. You know what I mean? Rainbows and birds. Nah, bro, this place is evil. The whole world is evil. You ain't gonna get too much peace out here. You're gonna get a hard way to go. And soon you ain't gonna get no peace when the missiles start flying. The Middle East is already being destroyed. Syria is in a pile of rubble. Raised tough out there in the wilderness. They hardened, you know what I mean, by living in the rocks. People out here living good. People raised up in America, they living all good. Then they go join the military.
Make sure you see that. Listen, Russian.